pop metal.
Welcome back, it's Half Bell Show, it's Half.
Blue Love.
String.
Alright, so...
I will take the reins.
This guy, not me.
Let Love take over.
I have heard this. String has heard this.
Yeah.
Hop has not heard
this. I don't know if I've heard this. I think I heard this song. I don't know if I've heard this song or not, for sure.
So
I might have a snippet of it.
You said Derek Charles.
Yeah,
he had dedicated this.
Well, he didn't dedicate
this. No, he didn't dedicate this.
He listens to a lot of heavy.
He listens to some really heavy stuff, and I think he had made a suggestion about this.
Well, let's just go ahead and put Bussy in there, too.
All right.
Heather works with, I can't remember. He likes the heavy stuff, too.
So Logan Stroderman, good friend of mine, he has a delicatessen in Harrisonburg, Lola. You've heard me probably talk about it on here. 4 years running now for the Reuben, best sandwich in Harrisonburg. So,
oh, that's killer.
Oh, so good. So good. Anybody that's around this area, comes around this area, definitely stop in there. But he sent this to me. So I cheated and I listened because I didn't know where we were going to go with this. And coming from Logan, I knew it was going to be heavy because that's what
Logan does.
Logan does. So I'll let you all give your opinions and I'll give my opinions on it afterwards. This just dropped like 11 days ago, about the same time Ginger's.
I said 2 weeks. So.
2 weeks. So around the same time Ginger's video came out, this came out also. I sent it to Bobby. Bobby dug it because I like to send Bobby my soothing sounds on Sundays. So I send him all kinds of stuff every now and again.
So soothing.
And this is far from soothing. I sent it to him on Father's Day, and Bobby said he had a good Father's Day. And
my neighbor Bobby?
Yeah. Okay. So you just want to jump into this?
Yeah,
and
let's just dive right deep.
I want to watch
balls deep into this.
I don't know if I'm gonna watch the video or watch Hop because.
Well, it's. Yeah.
Yeah.
Should we just go with it?
Let's go with it, man.
Just
go with it.
I'll just leave my headphones off.
You got to get the full Monty.
I'll watch the. Bam.
Oh, didn't mean to just kick you. To the hellfire and beyond. It stays like this too. That is fucking brutal! We'll be right back. For the damn things, Al. That shit is badass, man.
Lacuna Coil come up at the end of that song.
Oh, so Hop, let me hear it. You don't know what to say, do you?
I did like one part of that song. Well, actually, I like two parts. I like the part that come in at 6:04. I did like the guitar solo.
That guitar solo is ripping. And that drummer is fucking...
Yeah.
Vocals is a little too much for me, man.
I don't mind his growly vocals, but his... I call it pig's growls.
Yeah, that's why I did that.
I just can't... I don't like that style of vocals. I don't like it.
You listen to that on Father's Day at goddamn 5 in the morning. That'll get you
That song... I enjoyed that whole song. It's fucking brutal as hell. It's heavy. I mean, it had some good, just like sludgy, just
Matt
bottom end dropping out.
But that's like Matt, you know, that's the kind of music he gets.
It almost, his vocals there on his more, I don't know which, whatever that vocal style is, where his more sounds like a pig getting slaughtered.
Chihuahua. Well, it's like you can hear him coming on. It's like at the beginning, it sounds like we're at the beginning. And then it was just like,
but it's flames going. He kind of reminds me of Cradle of Filth, Danny Filth a little bit, just that style there.
Mm-hmm.
But then
that guttural.
But I couldn't quite make it out. Was that like a chorus, like a female, like underlying, like vocals, or was that like an organ, like keyboard?
I think
kind
a little
of a
bit
sound?
Of both, man. I think there's two singing there at the same time.
Well, it was like there was like some female like a chorus, like a choir or something would have. It was like an underline. It was real low.
And then you got that real guttural. Yeah. And then you got that high guttural.
I think it was all that same dude. Now, I could be wrong, but I think it was all him. But
that fucking drummer, man. Jesus Christ.
Well, I'm sitting here thinking,
You didn't know what to think.
How the hell do you even write a song like this?
How do you understand? I mean, I didn't understand any lyrics in it.
Always,
but.
You know, for example, Nikki Sixx always talked about that he carried around his book, write down stuff, you know, lyrics come to his head. What the hell? I don't even know how you even write down. I don't even know what the hell they're even saying.
I don't either, but.
I've always thought I listened to heavy shit, evidently.
Oh, there's heavy shit out there.
You haven't listened to heavy shit.
Logan sent that to me, and that was exactly what I texted him. I was like, the vocals was a bit too much.
I don't mind. Like,
the drumming was amazing, and that guitar solo.
Yeah, I like the solo. I liked everything about it.
The guitars, he smokes, because you could see him going. Was that
seven string?
Sweeps.
Yeah, it's like an eight or nine string.
I don't think
it's
it was
a
that
lot
many.
Of strings on
I don't
that.
Think it's like nine, but
going to when like the sweeps and stuff he was playing on that. It's like classical stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
yeah,
and so that right there told me that he's like
they got talent.
Yeah,
they have talent. It's yeah, and you know
I think it's a seven
that's
string.
That's what we are. You know, everybody has their own opinions, and you know, there's going to be people that just that's all they listen to is this mm-hmm. style of music, and they might think that we're you know. Posers or whatever, because we don't listen to it on the normal, but yeah, to each their own. But
yeah, it's
wow.
a seven string.
Seven string?
Yeah. It's positive in there.
I like it, but the vocalings is just a little
it's a bit
too
much.
Much.
And I had heard the beginning of it because I remember that it was kind of that mellow, but then after he started singing, I was like, yeah.
Now, what did you say about what Jose say?
No, that wasn't Jose. That was Sean the Butcher.
Sean the Butcher.
He was talking about Slaughter to Prevail. He said he thought when he heard Slaughter that was like the most brutal thing he'd ever
heard.
That's
what I'm saying.
And then he said, then he hears this band come out with this song, and then it was just like.
Because they've started playing this one already on the double dozen.
It's always like that, and that's what I thought, you know.
Just when you
there's
think
always going to be something.
I listened to Slaughter Prevail, you know, what, 2 months ago, and I'm like, holy shit. Well, that ain't the heaviest. Now we got into some Lorna Shore.
And see, we just hired Tim Waugh back. He was one of our prep cooks, and he finally came back to the fold. He listens to like a lot of Jamaican Rasta, you know, that type of good vibe feeling. And we were getting ready to.
Shit, this ain't been out a long time.
Yeah,
2 weeks.
Said 2 weeks.
Oh, yes.
We played that Slaughter to Prevail for him, and he just like curled up. So I'm like, sort of like how you.
He was like, no, no.
It's just a lot, man. It's a lot to take in.
And this band is the same way. There is just. Yeah, they're in your face, man. They are definitely in your face. I don't know. Anything? Y'all put in the like and the subscribes, comments.
I was trying to figure out
this band.
Where they were from. But.
Derek Charles probably knows.
And I could always ask Logan, and I'll send this one to Logan, which he subscribes. But
I'm not even going to make an attempt because it seems like I'd heard where they were from. But
I'm
probably getting it mixed up with
somebody
else. You all
put it in the comments for us. And if there's something not as less on that vocal growl, if they have something that's a little cleaner, but I figure.
It seems like I know they've been around for a little bit. It says they joined YouTube in 2009.
So that means they've been
and that seems like I remember hearing some stuff a while back, like years ago something, but I couldn't have told you what it was. And probably back then I wouldn't even have listened. I would have probably just like that turned it, but.
And that's what this show's all about. Like, you know, we just think of the spectrum of music we listened to within the last eight songs that we've listened to.
But we would have had to do this one last. I couldn't follow up.
Took it out of it.
We'll just cancel the YNT tonight.
Like, yeah, you're not going to follow YNT.
Yeah,
with that.
Well,
yeah.
It's going to ruin the whole song.
Yeah. Summertime,
girls. This song ain't even heavy at all.
Summertime. Hey, like
I can't
said,
even do
that,
a pig's
that,
growl.
That Grave Worm doing Little Runaway.
Oh God.
Man, that duo was something else. I wanted you to hear that one, but I thought this would be better. This was enough.
Not fun tonight.
No more.
And I said something like to Hop the other day about this. He was like, "Ooh." I was like, "You want to do it?" And he's like, "I don't know." Because I said, "Man, the vocals are they're something, man.
Yeah, they're something."
That's the only one I was looking forward to tonight.
He was biting at the chomp.
Yeah,
chomp at the bit.
All right, y'all ready to wrap this up?
Let's do it, man.
Yeah.
All right, 15 minutes in. Stay safe.
We done made everybody
like and subscribe.
Facebook.
You didn't say it.
Well, yeah. Learn how to love, man.
Forget how to hate. Thanks for having me.
Peace, y'all.